स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू अवर क्लास. विल कंटिन्यू दिस सेशन विद फर्दर क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. चिल्ड्रन, हियर अ फिगर इज गिवन एंड वी हैव टू आंसर द क्वेश्चन विद द रीजन. हियर इन द फॉलोइंग फिगर इज एंगल 1 एडजेसेंट टू एंगल 2, गिव रीजन. चिल्ड्रन, यू कैन सी द फिगर गिवन हियर वेयर एंगल 1 एंड एंगल 2 इज गिवन टू अस हियर, राइट हियर, एंड दे हैव आस्क्ड वेदर दे आर एडजेसेंट और नो. What do you feel? Are they adjacent, children? No, right? Because I feel that they are not adjacent because they do not share the common vertex. Okay, so from there that we'll answer here. Angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent angles because they do not have the same vertex. Okay, because they do not have the same vertex, they are not adjacent angles. Okay, let us go for the next question, children. Find the values of angle x, y and z in each of the following. Children, the figures are given to us. With the help of this figure, we have to find x, y and z. Okay, so let us start first with angle x. Children, you can see here, angle x and 55 degree are vertically opposite angles. That means, according to the rules, the vertically opposite angles are equal, right? So, you can see that angle x is 55 degree because it is vertically opposite angle. So, we got angle x. Now, let us go for angle y. You can see that angle x and y, they form linear pairs. Linear pair, what is the sum of linear pair, children? 180 degree, right? You can, so, we can say that angle x and angle y is 180 degree. You can see here angle x plus angle y is 180 degree. We got the value of x, that is 55 degree. So, I will substitute the value of x as 55 degree plus angle y equal to 180 degree. Now, taking 55 on the another side, it will be subtracted from 180. So, I will get angle y as 125 degree. So, I got angle y as 125 degree. Now, children, you can see angle y and angle z are vertically opposite angles. That means if angle y is 125, angle z will also be 125 only. Okay, so the last we will put it as angle y is equal to angle z because they are vertically opposite angles. Therefore, angle z is also 125 degree. So, step by step, children, we have to move here. Very easy to find here, okay? You use linears, vertically, alternates and you will get your answers. Let us go to this question number 2. Here, the given figure here, x, y and z we are asked to find here. First, children, let us go with z here because you can see 40 degree and angle z are vertically opposite angles. So, that means z is also 40 degree because they are vertically opposite angles. Now, children, you can see that for angle y and angle z, this is angle y and angle z are linear pair. That means they both sum up to 180 degree. So, angle y plus angle z is 180 degree because they form linear pairs. We have got the value of z here. Z we have got, that is 40 degree. So, substituting the value 40 degree here, angle y plus 40 degree equal to 180 degree. Taking 40 on another side to subtract, children, you will get angle y as 140 degree. Now, we got the value of angle y also, that is 140 degree. Now, children, you can see that here that 40 degree plus x plus 25, this part, this is also linear here. That means 40 plus x plus 25 degree will be equal to 180 degree, that is they form linear pairs. Now, we have got the value here of 40 and 25 that will add up to 65 degree plus angle x equal to 180 degree. Taking 65 on another side to subtract, we will get our answer, that is angle x, that is the last one remaining to find, will be equal to 115 degree. So, children, using step by step, we have to move ahead to find each and every angle. Next, children, question 13, we have fill in the blanks here. If two angles are complementary, then the sum of their measure is what, children? Yes, 90 degree, correct? Now, if two angles are supplementary, then the sum of their measures is what, children? It is 180 degree. Complementary as are 90 and supplementaries are 180. Next, third blank. Two angles forming a linear pair are always supplementary. Next, if two adjacent angles are supplementary, they form linear pair. Opposite of what we got earlier. If two lines intersect at a point, then the vertically opposite angles are always equal. That we have learned, children, in the theoretical part. And if two lines intersect at a point, and if one pair of vertically opposite angles are acute angles, then the other pair of vertically opposite angle is what? Obviously, it will be obtuse. Okay, if one is acute, other has to be obtuse. Question number 14. In the adjoining figure, name the following pairs of angle. Children, here with the help of this figure, we have to name the given angles. The first is obtuse, that is more than what? It is 80. It is between more than 90 and 180. That is obtuse but vertically opposite angles. So let us find which are they. Children, you can see here AOD, that is this angle. Angle AOD and angle BOC are vertically opposite angles and they are obtuse also. Okay, so this is our first answer. That is angle AOD and angle BOC are obtuse vertically opposite angles in the given figure. Now second, we have to find adjacent complementary angles. It has to be adjacent also and it has to be complementary also. Children, you can see here, this is a 90 degree, that is complementary. Therefore, EOA, that is this angle, and AOB, these two are they form 90 degree, that means they are pair of complementary angles, and also they are adjacent, the one and two, they are side by side, sharing common vertex and the common arm. Therefore, our answer is angle EOA and angle AOB are adjacent complementary angles. Next, children, equal supplementary angles. Now we have to find equal supplementary angles. That is, children, let us find both the angles should be supplementary, but they should be equal also. So that means we have to find such angles. Let us see from the figure, which are they? Yes, angle EOB, that is, this is the right angle. Equal means 180, if both has to be equal, each will be 90 degree, right? So angle EOB and angle EOD are equal supplementary angles in the given figure. Next, question number 4, unequal supplementary angles. So this here they have asked unequal supplementary angles. Let us see which are the unequal supplementary angles. Children, you can see here EOA, that is this angle, and angle EOC, that is this angle. They are supplementary because they form linear pairs also. And they are not equal also. Okay, so our answer is EOA and angle EOC are unequal supplementary angles in the given figure. Okay, now children, the last question we have here, the adjacent angles that do not form a linear pair. Children, you can see from the given figure, adjacent angle, that is AOB and angle AOE, they are adjacent angles but they do not form linears. Secondly, children, we have AOE and we have EOD, that is this angle. They are adjacent but they do not form linear. Okay, children, so let us go for what is with this, children. We end our first exercise 5.1. Study well. Until then, bye-bye.